yet of Hamlet, our dear brother's death, the memory be green. And it us befitted to bear our hearts in grief, and our whole kingdom to be contracted in one brow of woe. Yet so far hath discretion fought with nature that we with wisest sorrow think on him, together remembrance of ourself. Therefore, our sometime sister, now our queen, the imperial jointress of this warlike state, have we taken to wife. For all our thanks. And now, Laertes, what's the news with you? What should thou beg, Laertes, that would not be my offer, not thy asking?
My dread lord, your leave and favor to return to France, from whence though wittingly I came to Denmark to show my duty in your coronation, yet now I must confess that duty done, my thoughts and wishes bend again toward France, and bow them to your gracious leave and pardon.
Have you your father's leave? What says Polonius? He hath, my lord, wrung from me my slow leave by thy petition, and at last, upon his will, I sealed my heart and said, I do beseech you, give him leave to go. Take thy fair hour, Laertes, and time be thine.
In thy best graces, spend it at thy will.
And now, our cousin Hamlet and our son.
Less than kind.
Good Hamlet. Hamlet! Cast thy knight's color off. Thou knowest his comment. All that lives must die. Passing from nature to eternity.
I know. It is common.
It could be. Why seems it so particular with thee?
Seems? Madam, nay, it is. I know not seems. 'Tis not alone my inky cloak, good mother. No, and all the fruitful river in the eye, together with all forms, moods, shapes of grief. But I have that within which passeth so. These but the trappings and the suits of woe.
'Tis sweet and commendable in your nature, Hamlet, to give these mourning duties to your father. But you must know that your father lost a father, and that father lost his. And the survivor, bound in filial obligation for some term to do obsequious sorrow. But to persever in obstinate condolement is unmanly grief. We pray you, throw to earth this unprevailing woe. Think of us as of a father. For let the world take note, you are the most immediate to our throne. And with no less nobility of love than that which dearest father bears his son, do I impart to you. For your intent in going back to school in Wittenberg, we beseech you, and you remain here in the cheer and comfort of our eye, our chiefest courtier, cousin, and our son.
Let not thy mother lose her prayers, Hamlet. I pray thee, stay with us. Go not to Wittenberg.
You, madam.
'Tis a loving and gentle reply. Be as ourselves in Denmark. Come, madam. This gentle and unforced accord of Hamlet sits smiling to my heart. Come away.
Thank you.
soul flesh would melt, thaw, and resolve itself into a demon. Or that the Everlasting had not fixed his cannon against self-slaughter. Oh, God. God. How weary, stale, flat, and unprofitable seem to be all the uses of this world. Fire. Ah, fire. Tis an unweeded garden that grows to seed. Things rank and gross in nature possess it merely. That it should come to this, but 2 months dead. Nay, not so much, not 2. So excellent a king that was to this Hyperion, to a satyr! So loving to my mother that he might not fatigue the winds of heaven, visit her face too roughly. Heaven and earth must I remember. For she would hang on him, as if increase in appetite had grown by what it fed on. And yet, within a month, oh, let me not think on it. Vanity, thy name is woman! A little month! Or ere those shoes were old with which she followed my poor father's body, like Naomi, all tears. For she, even she, married with my uncle, my father's brother, but no more like my father than I to Hercules! Within a month, she married. Oh, most wicked speed to post with such dexterity to incestuous sheets. It is not, nor it cannot come, to good. But break my heart, for I must hold my tongue.
Hail to your lordship.
I'm glad to see thee well.
Our duty to your honor. Your loves is mine to you, farewell. My father's spear in arms, all is not well. I doubt some foul play. Oh, would the night were come! Till then sit still, my soul. Foul deeds will rise, though all the earth o'erwhelm them to men's eyes.
The perfume and suppliance of a minute. No more.
No more, but so.
Think it no more. Perhaps he loves you now, but you must fear. He may not, as unvalued persons do, carve for himself. For on his choice depends the safety and health of this whole state. Be wary, then. Best safety lies in fear. He to itself rebels, though not as near.
I shall the effect of this good lesson keep. As watchman to my heart. But, good my brother, do not, as some ungracious pastors do, show me the steep and thorny way to heaven, whilst, like a puffed and reckless libertine, himself the primrose path of dalliance treads, and recks not his own reed.
Oh, Rose of May!
And here, Laertes, aboard for shame you are stayed for.
There, my blessing with thee.
And these few precepts in thy memory see thou care. Give thy thoughts no tongue, nor any unproportioned thought whose act. Be thou familiar, but by no means vulgar. Those friends thou hast in their adoption tried, grapple them to thy soul with hoops of steel. But do not dull thy palm with entertainment of each new hatched, unfledged comrade. Beware of entering to a quarrel, but be then fair to depose it, make you wear thee. Give every man thy ear, but feel thy voice. Take each man's censure, but preserve thy judgment. Costly thy habits at first can buy, but well expressed in fancy. Rich, not gaudy, for the apparel oft proclaims the man. Neither
a barber nor a lender be.
For loan oft loses both itself and friend, and borrowing dulls the edge of husbandry. This, above all, to thine own self be true. And it must follow as night and day, thou canst not then be false to any man. Farewell.
My blessing season is in thee.
Most humbly do I take my leave, my lord.
I invite you, go, so instead.
Farewell, Ophelia. And remember well what I have said to you.
Tis in my memory locked, and you yourself shall be the key of it.
What is the fee it said you?
So please you, something touching the Lord Hamlet.
What is between you? Give me up the truth.
He hath, by royal play, made many tenders of his affection to me.
Affection? Foo! You speak like a green girl, unsuited to such parent circumstance. Do you believe these tenders, as you call them?
I do not know, my lord, what I should think.
Mary, I'll teach you. Think yourself a baby, that you have tamed these tenders for true pay, which are not sterling. Tender yourself more dearly, you'll tender me a fool.
He hath, my lord, and virtued me with love and honorable fashion.
Aye, springes to catch woodcocks. I would not, in plain terms, from this time forth, have you so slander any moment leisure as if your talk with the Lord Hamlet.
shall obey, my lord.
The air bites shrewdly. It's very cold.
It is a nipping and an eager air.
What am I now?
I think it lasts 12. No, it is struck.
Indeed?
I heard it not.
Look! Behold, it comes! Angels and ministers of grace, defend us! Be thou a spirit of health or goblin damned! I will speak to thee. I will call thee Hamlet. King! Father! O royal Dane, answer me!
Beckons you to go away with it. As if summoned Parthenon, it did desire you alone.
Look, what courteous action weighs you to a more removed crown. But do not go with it.
No, by no means.
Will thou speak, then will I follow it.
Not, my lord.
Why? What should be the fear? I do not set my life in a pin's feet. As for my soul, what can it do to that? Being a thing immortal as itself. It waves me forth again. I'll follow it.
What if it comes toward the dreadful cliff that feels over space into the sea? And there assume some other orb of form to draw you into madness!
You wait me still.
Go on! I'll follow thee!
You shall not go!
Off your hands!
You throw me! You shall not go!
Still am I called!
Unhand me, gentlemen! By heaven! I'll make a ghost of him that left me! I stay away!
Denmark be a couch for luxury and damned incest, but howsoever thou choosest act, change not thy mind. Nor let thy soul contrive against thy mother aught. Leave her to heaven. Very well it was. The glowworm shows the morning to be near, and begins to pale his ineffectual fire. And you, remember me!
Oh, all you host of heaven! Oh, earth! What else shall I couple hell? Oh, my. Hold my heart. Remember thee. I, thou poor ghost, while memory holds a seat in this distracted globe, yes, by heaven, O most pernicious woman! Oh, villain! Smile, damned villain! Meet it is, I set it down, that one may smile, and be a villain! At least, I am sure, it may be so in Denmark! So, uncle, there you are. It is, adieu. Remember me. I have sworn.
My lord!
Hamlet!
So
be it.
My lord!
How is my noble lord?
Good news, my lord.
Oh, wonderful.
Good, then tell it.
No, you reveal it.
Not I, my lord, by heaven.
Nor I, my lord. Say you did. Would hard a man once think it, but you'll be secret.
How, my lord?
Then, my good friends, as you are friends, scholars, and soldiers, give me one poor request.
What is, my lord? We will.
Never to speak of this that you have seen.
Day and night, but this is wondrous strange!
Therefore, as a stranger, give it welcome! There are more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of in your philosophy! But come! How strange, or odd, soe'er I bear myself, as I, perchance hereafter, shall think fit to put an antique disposition on, swear that you, at such time seeing me, never shalt to note that you know aught of me. So grace and mercy at your most needs help you.
Swear!
Rest. Atonement spirit. So, gentlemen, with all my love, I do commend me to you. Let us go in together, but still your fingers on your lips, I pray. The time is up, join us. Come, let's go in together.
By the wrist and held me hard, and goes he to the ledge.
my sweet Gertrude, that he hath found the head and source of your son's distemper.
No. I doubt it is no other but the main. His father's death and our or hasty marriage.
Your Majesty. Dear Rosencrantz, gilded sir, the need we have to use you did provoke our hasty sending. Something have you heard of Hamlet's transformation? What it should be, more than his father's death, I cannot dream of. I entreat you both, that being of so young days brought up with him, to draw him on to pleasure, and to gather, so much as from occasion you may glean, whether aught to us unknown afflicts him thus, that open lies within our remedy.
We both obey, and here come ourselves in the full debt.
To lay our service freely at your feet, to be commanded.
Thanks, Rosencrantz, and gentle Guildenstern.
Thanks, Guildenstern, and gentle Rosencrantz. I beseech you instantly to visit my too much changed son.
Heavens may his, our presence and our practices be pleasant and helpful to him.
Aye, amen.
My liege and madam, to expostulate what majesty should be, what duty is, why day is day, night is night, time is time, were nothing but to wait night, day is day. Therefore, since brevity is the soul of wit, and tedious is the limbs and outward flourishes, I will be brief. My noble son is mad. Mad call I it, for to define true madness, what is it? Nothing else but mad, but let that
more
go.
More matter with less art.
Madam, I swear I use no art at all. But he is mad, tis true. Tis true, tis pity. And pity tis true, a foolish figure. But farewell, for I would use no art. I have whilst she is mine, who in duty and obedience of art hath given me this. Now, gather and surmise. To the celestial and my soul's idol, the most beautified Ophelia. That's an ill phrase. A vile phrase. Beautified is a vile phrase. But farewell, it. You shall hear it thus.
Came this from Hamlet to her.
Madam, stay a while. We'll be faithful. Doubt thou the stars of fire? Doubt that the sun doth move. Doubt truth to be a liar. But never doubt I love. Thine evermore whilst this machine is to him, Hamlet. This in obedience hath my daughter shown me.
And hath she received his love?
What do you think of me?
As a man faithful and honorable.
I would fain prove so. What might you think? When I had seen this hot love on the wing, what might you think? No, I went round to work, and my young mistress I need to speak. Lord Hamlet's the prince, out of thy sphere, this must not be. And then I precept gave her that she should lock herself in his resort, admit no messengers, receive no tokens, and having done so, she took the fruits of my advice, and he repulsed, fell into a sadness. And by this declension into the madness where now he rages and all he wail for.
Do you think 'tis this?
Maybe very likely.
Hath there been such a time I'd fain to know that I had possibly said 'tis so when it proved otherwise?
Not that I know.
Then take this from this if this be otherwise. You know, sometimes he walks for hours together in the lobby.
So he does indeed.
On such a time, I'll loose my arm to him. Be you and I behind the arras then. Mark the encounter. If he love her not, and not from his reason fallen thereon, let me be no assistant to estate.
We'll try it.
But so sadly the poor wretch comes leaving.
Away. I do beseech you both away. I'll board it presently. Give me leave. How was my good Lord Hamlet?
Well!
God have mercy.
Do you know me, my lord?
Excellent well. You are a fishmonger.
Not I, my lord.
Ah, then I would you were so honest a man.
Honest, my lord?
Aye, sir. To be honest, as this world goes, is to be one man picked out of 10,000.
That's very true, my lord.
For if the sun breed maggots in a dead dog, being a god-kissing carrion. Have you a daughter?
I have, my lord.
Let her not worry the sun. Conception is a blessing, but not as your daughter may see. Friend, look to it.
Still harping on my daughter, yet he knew me not at first. He said I was a fishmonger. He's far gone. Far gone. I'll speak to him again. What do you mean, my lord?
Words. Words.
Words. What is the matter, my lord?
Between who?
I mean the matter that you read, my lord.
Slander, sir. For the satirical slave says here that old men have gray beards, that their faces are wrinkled, their eyes purging thick amber and plum tree gum, and that they have a plentiful lack of wit, together with most weak hands. All which, sir, though I most powerfully and potently believe, yet I hold it not honesty to have it thus set down. For you yourself, sir, should be as old as I am, if, like a crab, you could go backward.
Though this be madness, yet there's method in it. Will you walk out of the air, my lord?
Into my grave.
Thought is at the air. Ah! How pregnant his replies sometimes are. I will leave him suddenly and contrive a means of meeting between him and my daughter. My honorable lord, I'll most humbly take my leave of you.
You cannot, sir, take from me anything that I will more willingly part with all, except my life. Except my life. Ah! Except my life!
Ah! Very well, my lord. These tedious old fools.
How do ye both?
As the indifferent children of the earth.
Happy in that we're not over happy.
Unfortunate cap, we are not the very button.
Oh, what's the news?
None, my lord, but that the world's grown honest.
Then is doomsday here, but your news is not true. Let me question more in particular. What have you, my good friends, deserved at the hands of fortune that she sends you to prison hither?
A prison, my lord?
Denmark's.
That is the world one.
A goodly one, in which there are many confines, wards, and dungeons. Denmark being one of the worst.
We think not so, my lord.
Why then, 'tis not to you, for there is nothing either good or bad, but thinking that is so. To me, it is a prison.
Why then, your ambition makes it one. 'Tis too narrow for your mind.
Oh, God. I could be bound in a nutshell, but count myself a king of infinite space. Were it not that I have bad dreams.
Oh.
Which dreams indeed are but ambition, for the very substance of the ambitious is merely the shadow of a dream.
A dream itself is but a shadow.
Truly, and I hold ambition of so airy and light a quality that it is but a shadow's shadow.
A shadow's shadow.
Shall we the court?
We'll wait upon you.
No, such matter. But, in the beaten way of friendship, what make you an Elsinore?
Why, to visit you, my lord. No other occasion.
Beggar that I am even poor in thanks. But, I thank you. Were you not sent for? Come, deal justly with me. Speak.
What should we say, my lord?
Why, anything but to the purpose. You were sent for. And there is a kind of confession in
in your looks, which your modesties have not craft enough to color. I know the good king and queen have sent for you.
To what end, my lord?
Be even and direct with me, whether you were sent for or no!
What say you?
Hey, I have an eye for you. If you love me, hold not off.
My lord, we were sent for.
I will tell you why. I have of late, but wherefore I know not, lost all my earth. Forgone all custom of exercises. Indeed, it goes so gently with this disposition that this goodly frame, the earth, seems to me a sterile promontory. Oh, what a piece of work is man! How noble in reason, how infinite in faculties. Yet, man delights not me.
Oh!
No, no, woman, neither. But by your smile, you seem to say so.
My lord, if you delight not in men, what lent and entertainment the players shall receive from you? He overtook them on the way, and hither are they coming to offer you service.
What players are they?
Even those you are wont to take such delight in. The tragedians of the city.
There are the players.
Welcome! Now you should come hither, my lord. Friends, I will leave you tonight. You all welcome at Elsinore. You are welcome, masters. Welcome all. I am glad to see thee well. Good, my lord. We see the players well bestowed. Do you hear? Let them be well used, for they are the abstracts and the brief chronicles of the time. After your death, you had better have a bad epitaph than their ill report while you live.
My lord, I will use them according to their deserts.
Odds, fucking man, better! Use every man according to his deserts, and whom should say whipping? Use them after your own honor and dignity. The less they deserve, the more merit is in your bounty. Take them in.
Come, sirs.
Follow him, friends. We'll hear a play tomorrow. And just now, hear me, oh friend. Could you play The Murder of Gonzaga?
I will.
Very well. We'll have tomorrow night. Could you, for a need, study a speech of some dozen or 16 lines which I would set down and insert in? Could you not?
I will.
Very well. Follow that lord, and look you mocking not.
Good, my lord.
I shall gladly with you. Now I am alone. Oh, what a rogue and peasant slave am I! Is it not monstrous that this player, but in a fiction, in a dream of passion, could force her soul so to her own conceit that all her visage waved, tears in her eyes, distraction in her aspect, her broken voice, and her whole function suited with form to her conceit, and all for nothing! What would she do had she the motive and the cue for passion that I have? She would drown the stage with tears, cleave the general ear with horrid speech, confound the ignorant, amaze indeed the very faculties of eyes and ears. Yet I, a dull and muddy metal rascal, peak and can say nothing. No. Not for a king upon whose property and most dear life a damned defeat was made. Am I a coward? Zooms, I should take it, for it cannot be, but I am pigeon-livered and lack gall to make a prescient bidder. Why, in this, I should have fatted all the region kites with this slave offer! Oh, bloody, bloody villain! Remorseless, treacherous, kindless, lecherous villain! Oh, vengeance! This is most brave that I, the son of a dear father, murdered, prompted to my revenge by heaven and hell, must, like a whore, unpack my heart with words and fall a cursing like a very drab, a scullion! Fire pump,
Foe! About my brain. Oh, cursed spite, that ever I was born to set it right!
Gracious, so please you, we will bestow ourselves here and here.
Sweet Gertrude, leave us too. We have closely sent for Hamlet hither, that he may hear affront Ophelia. The father and myself will so bestow ourselves that we can frankly judge of their encounter if it be the affliction of love or no that thus he suffers from.
I shall obey you. And for your part, Ophelia, I do wish your good beauty would be the happy cause of Hamlet's wildness. So shall I hope your good virtue will bring you to the appointed way to both your honors.
Madam, I wish it may.
Ophelia, what do you hear? I hear him coming. Let us withdraw, my lord.
Perfect. which gifts wax poor when givers prove unkind. There, my
lord. Are you honest? Are you fair?
What means your lordship?
That if you be honest and fair, your honesty should allow no discourse to your beauty.
But beauty, my lord, have better colors than with honesty.
Transform honesty from what it is into a god! And the force of honesty can translate beauty into his likeness. I did love him once.
Indeed, my lord, you made me
believe so. You should not have believed me, I loved you not.
I was the more deceived.
Get thee to a nunnery. Why wouldst thou be a breeder of sinners? I myself am indifferent, honest. And yet, I could accuse me of such things that it were better my mother had not borne me. We are errant knaves all. Believe none of us. Go thy ways to a nunnery. Where's your father?
In his soul over which his melancholy sits unbrewed, and I do doubt the hatch and disclose will be some danger, which for to prevent, thus set it down, he will with speed to England. What you think on it
shall do well. Now, Free, you need not tell us what the Lord Hamlet said. You heard it all. My lord, if you hold it fit, play, let his queen mother all alone entreat him to show his grief. Let her be bound with him. Shall be placed, so please you, in the ear of all the conference. She find him not to England send him, for confine him where your wisdom best shall think.
Shall be so. Madness in great ones must not unwatched go.
Ha!
Ha!
Ha! Hands
apt.
Hands apt.
Hands up.
Apt.
Apt. Strike that.
Speak the sweet, I pray, as I pronounced it to you, trippingly on the tongue. But if you mouth it, as many of your players do, I had as lief the town crier spoke my lines. No, do not saw the air too much with your hand thus. But use all gently, for in the very torrent, tempest, and as I may say, whirlwind of passion, you must acquire and beget a temperance that will give it smoothness. Oh, it offends me to the soul to hear a robustious, hairy-painted fellow tear a passion to tatters, to very rags, to split the ears of the groundlings, who for the most part are capable of nothing more than inexplicable dumb shows and noise. I would have such a fellow whipped for o'erdoing termagant. In our parent tariff, pray you avoid it.
I would, Charlie.
Oh, shepherd. Be not too tame, neither. But let your own discretion be your tutor. Suit the action to the word to the action. Let you overstep not the modesty of nature. For anything so overdone is from the purpose of playing, whose end, both at the first and now, was and is to hold, as twere, the mirror of its nature. Show virtue for our feature. Scorn her image and the very age and body of the time, this form and pressure.
I hope we have restored her. Fairly well with us, sir.
Oh, reform it altogether, and let those that play your clowns speak no more than is set down for them.
Oh.
For there be of them that will themselves laugh, to set on some quantity of barren spectators to laugh too. Though in the meantime, some necessary question of the play be then to be considered.
Oh.
That's villainous, and shows a most pitiful ambition in the fool that uses it. Go make you ready! What orders you?
Yes, sweet lord. At your service.
Observe my uncle. Give him heedful note. While they are coming to the play, I must be idle. Get you a place!
If he's still off, whilst this play is playing and escape detecting, I will pay the debt.
I have heard that guilty creatures sitting at a play have by the very cunning of the scene been struck so to the soul that they have presently proclaimed their malefactions. For murder, though it hath no tongue, will speak with most miraculous organ. I'll have these players play something like the murder of my father before mine uncle. I'll observe his looks. I'll attend him to the quick. If he but blench, I know my course. The spirit I have seen may be the devil. And the devil hath the power to assume a pleasing shape, yea, and perhaps out of my weakness and my melancholy abuses me to damn. I'll have grounds more relative than this. The play's the thing wherein I'll catch the conscience of the king!
Words are not mine.
No, nor mine now. My lord, you played one went to the university, you said?
Ah, that I did, my lord, and counted as an actor.
What did you enact?
I did enact Julius Caesar! I was killed in Capitol. Brutus killed me.
It was a brute part of him to kill so capital a cat there.
Be the players ready. Aye, my lord, they stay upon your patience.
Come hither, my dear Hamlet, sit by me.
No, good mother, here's metal more attractive.
Oh, do you mark that?
Lady, may I lie in your lap?
Lord?
I mean, my head upon your lap.
Aye, my lord.
Did you think I meant country matters?
I think nothing, my lord.
That's a fair thought, to lie between maid's legs.
What is, my lord? How dare you, my lord?
Who, I? Aye,
my lord.
Oh, your only jig maker. For what should a man do but be merry? But look you how cheerfully my mother looks. And my father died within 2 hours.
Nay, tis twice 2 months, my lord.
So long. Oh, heavens, died 2 months ago and not forgotten yet. Then there's hope. A great man's memory may outlive his life half a year. Ah!
For us, and for our tragedy, here, stooping to your clemency, we beg your hearing patiently.
Is this a prologue or the posy of a ring?
As woman's love.
Full 30 times at Phoebus' cart gone round Neptune's salt wash and Terra's orbit ground. Since love our hearts and Hymen did our hands unite, commutual in most sacred bands.
So many journeys may the sun and moon make us again count, or ere love be done.
Faith, I must leave thee, love, and shortly too. My operant powers their functions leave to do. And thou shalt live in this fair world behind, honored, beloved, and happily one as kind, for husband
oh,
shall—
Oh, confound the rest. Such love must need be treason in my breast. In second, husbands, let me be accursed. None wed the second, but who killed the first?
Wormwood! Wormwood!
The second time I kill my husband dead, when second husband kisses me in bed.
'Tis deeply sworn. Sweet, leave me here a while. My spirits grow dull, and fain I would beguile this tedious day with sleep.
Sleep rot thy brain, and never let mischance come between us twain.
Madam, how like you this play?
Lady protests too much, methinks.
Oh, but she'll keep her word.
What do you call the play?
The Mousetrap. The play is the image of a murder done in Vienna. 'Tis a knavish piece of work. Well, what of that? Your Majesty and we that have free souls, it touches us not. This is one Lucianus, nephew to the king.
Thoughts black. Pens out, drug fit in time a dream. Confederate season, else no creature seen. Thou mixture rank, with midnight weeds collected, with Hecate's band, thrice blasted, thrice infected. Thy natural magic and dire property, when wholesome life usurp immediately.
He poisons him in the garden for his estate. You shall see anon how the murderer gets the love of the king's wife.
King rises?
What? Brightened with false fire?
Where is my lord?
My lord,
your majesty.
Give me light. Away!
The lights! Bring him light! Clear the way for the
king! Bring him light!
Ah! Horatio! I'll take the ghost word for £1,000. Disproceed.
Aye, my lord.
Upon the talk of the poison.
I did very well note him.
Good, my lord!
Vouchsafe me a word with you.
Sir, the whole history.
The king, sir.
I saw one of him.
Is in his retirement marvelous distemper?
With trick, sir?
No, my lord, rather with honor.
Your wisdom should show itself more rich and signify this to the doctor. For me to put him to his purgation should perhaps plunge him into far more color.
Good, my lord, put your discourse into some frame and start not so wildly from my affair.
I am king, sir. Pronounce.
The queen, your mother, in most great affliction of spirit, hath sent me to you
mother. But is there no sequel at the heels of this mother's admiration?
She desires to speak with you in her closet ere you go to bed.
We shall obey. Were she 10 times our mother. Have you any further trade with us?
Good, my lord. What is the cause of your distemper? You do surely bar the door upon your own liberty when you deny your griefs to your friend.
Madam, I lack advancement.
How can that be? Would you have the voice of the king himself for your succession in Denmark?
Aye, madam, but as the grass grows, the proverb is something must be.
My lord, if our duty be too bold, our love is too unmannerly.
I do not well understand that. Will you play upon this pipe?
My lord, I cannot.
Oh, I do beseech you!
Believe me, I cannot.
I do pray!
I know no touch of it, my lord.
'Tis as easy as lying. Govern these vintages with your finger and thumb, give it breath with your mouth, and will discourse most eloquent music. Look, you hear the stops!
But these cannot I command to any utterance of harmony. I have not the skill.
You would play upon me! You would seem to know my stops! You would pluck out the heart of my mystery! Would sound me from my lowest note to the top of my compass, and there is much excellent voice, excellent music in this little organ, yet cannot you make it speak? Blood! Am I easier to be played on than a pipe? Call me what instrument you will, but you can fret, you cannot play upon me.
God bless you, sir.
My lord, the queen will speak with you in presently. Do you see on the cloud that's almost
by the mass, and is like a camel.
Methinks it is like a weasel.
It is back like a weasel.
Or like a whale.
Very like a whale.
Then will I come to my mother by and by?
I will tell her so.
By and by is easily said. To my mother. Oh, heart, lose not thy nature. I must be cruel, not unnatural. I will speak daggers to her, but use none. How in my words soever she be sent, to give them seals, never my soul consent.
My offense is rank. It smells to heaven. It hath the primal eldest curse upon it. A brother's murder. Pray, can I not, though inclination be as sharp as will? What if this cursed hand were thicker than itself with brother's blood? Is there not rain enough in the sweet heavens to wash it white as snow? What form of prayer can serve my turn? Forgive me my foul murder, that cannot be, since I am still possessed of those effects for which I did the murder, my crown, my own ambition, and my queen. May one be pardoned and retain the offense? Wretched state! O bosom black as death, O limed soul that, struggling to be free, art more engaged! Help, angels! Make us say, bow, stubborn knees,
heart with strings of steel, made soft as sinuous as the newborn babe. Oh, maybe well. Now he is a prey, and now I'll do it. And so he goes to heaven, and so am I revenged. That would be scant. A villain kills my father, and for that I, his sole son, do the same villain send to heaven. This is higher in salary, not revenge. Up, sword, and know thou a more horrid pet. When he is drunk asleep, or about some act that has no relish of salvation in it, then trip him, that his heels may kick at heaven, and that his soul may be as black and damned as hell whereto it goes. My mother says, this physic but prolongs thy sickly days.
My words fly up. Thoughts remain below. Words without thoughts never to heaven.
Your Majesty, he will come swiftly. Look you lay hold to him.
How's that to be here?
This was your husband.
Look you now and follows. Here is your husband, like a mildewed ear, blasting his wholesome brother. Have you eyes? Could you on this fair mountain leave to feed and batten on this moor? Ha! Have you eyes? You cannot call it love. For at your age, the heyday of love is tame. It's humble and waits for the judgment. And what judgment could step from this to this? Oh, shame, where is thy blood?
Speak no more. Thou turnst mine eyes into my very soul.
Nay, I to live in the rank sweat of an inch deep.
No!
How is it with you, lady?
Less. How is it with you? How on do you look?
On him? On him? Look you how pale he glares!
To whom do you speak this?
You see nothing there.
Nothing at all, yet all is that I see.
Nor did you nothing hear.
Nothing but ourselves.
Look, look where it steals away. My father in his habit as he lived. Oh, look where it goes even now at the bottom. Oh, throw away the worser part of it, and live the purer with the other half. Good night, but go not to my uncle's bed. Assume a virtue if you have it not. For the same Lord, I do repent. But heaven hath pleased it to punish me with this, and this with me, that I must be their scourge and minister. I will bestow it. And answer well the death I gave him. And so, again, good night. I must be cruel, only to be kind. Thus bad begins, and worse remains behind. One word more, good lady.
What shall I do?
I must to England, you know that.
Alack. I had forgotten. So
my two schoolfellows, whom I will trust as I will Adder's fane, they bear the mandate. They must sweep my way and marshal me to knavery. Let it work. This man shall set me packing. I'll lug the guts into the neighbor room. Mother, good night. Indeed, this counselor is most still, most secret, and most grave. Who was in life a foolish, prating knave. Come, sir. Draw toward an end with you.
True nature is each toy seems prologue to some great amiss. See, the little art is jealousy, is guilt.
your son. What, Gertrude? How does Hamlet?
As mad as the sea and wind, both be tin, which is the mightier. The fall is fit behind the harris here, and something stir. He whips out his rapier, and he cries, a rat! A rat! And in his brain and apprehension, he kills the unseen good old man.
Indeed. It should have been so with us had we been here. Where is he gone?
To draw apart the body he hath killed. For whom his very madness he weeps for what is done.
We will ship him hence. Ho! Oh, kill him, sir! Hamlet and madness hath Polonius slain, and from his mother's closet hath he dragged him. Go, I pray you, seek him out. Hasten this. Come, Gertrude. Come away. My soul is filled with discord and dismay.
Safe restored. Have all occasions to inform against me and spare my dull revenge. What is a man? If the chief market and good of his time be but to sleep and feed. A beast, nothing more. Oh, from this time forth, my thoughts be bloody, but be nothing worse. Creatures knows to fat us, and we fat ourselves for maggots. That's the end. In heaven! If your messenger finds him not there, seek him in the other place yourself. What? find him not within this month, you shall note him as you go up the stairs into the lobby.
Go, seek him there.
You shall stay till you come.
Hamlet, we must send thee hence with fiery quickness. Therefore, prepare thyself. The bark is ready, and everything is bent in England.
For England!
Aye, Hamlet.
Good!
So is it, if thou knowest our purpose.
Oh, I see a cherub that sees them. But come, for England. Farewell, dear mother.
Thy loving father.
My mother. Father and mother is man and wife. Man and wife is one flesh. And so, my mother. Oh. Come, for England!
Away. Everything else is sealed and done, just leans on this affair. I pray you, haste in this. The present death of Hamlet. Do it, England, for like the hectic in my blood, he rages, and thou must cure me. Till I know 'tis done. However my haps, my joys have ne'er begun.
Shut up.
king, give me my father!
What's the cause, Laertes, that thy rebellion looks so giant-like? Let him go, Gertrude. Tell me, Laertes, why art thou thus insolent? Let him go, Gertrude! Speak, man.
Where is my father?
Dead.
But not by
him. Let him demand his fill.
How came he dead? I'll not be juggled with to hell, legions, bound to the blackest devil. That tongue must come, only I'll be revenged most thoroughly for my father.
Lord Laertes, if thou desire to know the certainty of your dear father's death, is it writ on your revenge that you should draw on friend and foe? Winner and loser, would you know them then?
Good friend, thus why hollow my arms?
Now you speak like a good child and a true gentleman. I am guiltless of your father's death. And most sensibly in grief for it.
Not now, what noise is that?
Wits and didst persuade revenge, it could not move thus.
How should I return all now from another one?
By his cockle hands that and his handle shall. Tomorrow is St. Valentine's Day, all in the morning bedtime, and I have made it your window to be your Valentine!
Patience to us, and we shall jointly labor with your soul to give it due content. I pray you, go with me. What are they that would speak with me?
Salem, sir. He says he has letters for you.
Let you come in. I do not know from what part of the world I should be greeted, if not from Lord Hamlet.
There's a letter for you, sir. It comes from the ambassador that was bound for you. Your name is Horatio, if I'm not known.
Horatio, when thou shalt have overlooked this, give this fellow fee for his pains. Rosencrantz and Guildenstern, I'll
Okay. Once in France, Guildenstern. Dead. Once we set sail for England, Brogue died to find out their packet. The Grand Commission was an exact command of the King of England my head should be struck off. I withdrew and devised a new commission, that on the view and know of these contents, England should the bearers put to sudden death, no shriving time allowed. I subscribed it, gave it the impression of the Danish seal and placed it safely back with Rosencrantz and Guildenstern. Changeling never known. They did make love to this dreadful employment and are not near my conscience. This good sailor will bring thee where I am. Farewell. He that thou knowest thine Hamlet. Come. I will give you fee for your pains. Direct me to him whom you brought this.
Now you must put me in your heart for friend, since you have heard that he which hath your noble father slain pursued my life.
Well, appears. But tell me why you proceed not against these feats.
The queen, his mother, lives almost by his books. For myself, she is so conjunctive to my heart and soul that I could not but by her. The other motive is the great love the general gender bear him, who convert his gibes to graces.
And so have I a noble father lost, a sister driven into desperate turns. But my revenge will come.
Rake not your sleeves for that. How now? What news?
Letters, my lord, from Hamlet.
From Hamlet? Who brought them?
Sailors, my
lord. Leave us. High and mighty, you will know that I am set naked on your kingdom. Tomorrow I will beg leave to see your kingly eyes when I shall recount the sudden and more strange return. Hamlet, what should this be? Are all the rest come back, or is this some abuse and no such thing?
Know you the hand?
'Tis Hamlet's character. Make it. Hear the postscript alone. Can you advise him?
I am lost in him, my lord. But let him come. It warms the very sickness in my heart that I shall tell him to his teeth. Thus didst thou!
If this be true, you will be ruled by me.
Aye, my lord. So you will not go rule me to a peace?
To thine own peace. Stay with me.
Thank you.
my lord. I have a speech of fire that fain would blaze, but that this folly drowns it. How should I, your true love, now from another? Let us follow it. How much I had to do to calm his rage. Now fear I this wheel start again. Let us follow.
When the news, when I did love, we thought it was very sweet. We were the time for, I hope, we thought there was nothing neat.
This fellow, no feeling of his feelings that he sings, great me.
Custom hath made it him a property of easiness.
To see him so, the hand of his employment hath a daintier sense.
To the time for, that he hath shipped me until the land. Then there was nothing meet.
Whose grave's this, sirrah?
Mine, sir.
I think it be thine indeed, for thou liest it.
You lie out, aunt, sir, therefore 'tis not yours. For my part, I do not lie it, yet it is mine.
Thou dost lie it, to be it to say it is thine. 'Tis for the dead, not for the quick, therefore thou liest.
'Tis a quick lie, sir, and 'twill away again from me to you.
What man dost thou take it for?
No man, sir.
What woman then?
For none neither.
Who is to be buried in it?
One that was a woman, sir, but rest her soul, she's dead.
How absolute the knave is. We must speak by a card, or equivocation will undo us. How long hast thou been a grave maker?
Of all the days of the year, I came to it that day that our last King Hamlet overcame Fortinbras.
How long is that since?
Can you not tell that? Every fool can tell that. The very day that our young Hamlet, he that is mad, and sent into England.
Aye, Mary, why was he sent into England?
Why? Because he was mad. He shall recover his wits there, or if he do not, there be no great match there.
How came he mad?
Very strangely, they say.
How strangely?
Faith, e'en with losing his wits.
Upon what ground?
Why, here in Denmark.
How long will a man lie in the earth ere he rot?
Faith, if he be not rotten before he die, he will last you some 8 or 9 years. Here's a skull now. This skull hath lain in the earth 23 years.
Whose was it?
A whoreson. A mad fellow's it was. Whose do you think it was?
Nay, I know not.
Pestilence on it for a mad rogue. This skull, sir, for Yorick's skull, the king's jester.
This.
He and that.
Let me see. Alas, for Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. Fellow of infinite jest. Most excellent fantasy. He hath borne me on his back 1,000 times. And yet, how horror than my imagination it is. Here hung those lips, one which I have kissed I know not how oft. Love, where be your gibes now? Your gambols, your songs, your flashes of merriment. I will want to set the table on our own. What base use as we return her, Horatio?
Were to consider too curiously to consider so.
No, faith, not a just. But to follow these us with modesty enough, and likelihood to lead it, as thus, imperious Caesar, dead and turned to clay, might stop a hall to keep the wind away. Oh, that that earth which kept the world in awe should catch, expel the winter's thaw. Soft enough, here comes the king, comes the king, the queen, the courtiers. Who's at the foe? Such main bright. This doth betoken the course they follow deep. Desperate hand, or do its own life. As of some state. Couch me well, mark.
What ceremony else?
Her obsequies have been as far enlarged as we have warranties. Her death was doubtful. And, but that great commander sways the order, she should in ground.
Charles, not a ministering angel shall my sister be, when thou liest howling.
What the Pharaoh feel?
Anoint my sword. I brought an unction of a mountebank so mortal that where it draws blood, no pulses can save the thing from death that is but scrapped withal. I'll touch my point with this contagion that, if I gall him slightly, it may be death.
If this should fail, this project should have a back or a second. That it might hold if this did blast in proof. I have it. When in your motion, you are hot and dry and he calls for drink, I'll have prepared a chalice for the occasion. Whereupon, but sipping, if ye by chance escaped your venom stuck, our purpose shall hold there. Ah, now, an hour of quiet thereby shall we see. Till then, in patience our proceeding be.
I'm very sorry, good Horatio. As Hilarities, I forgot myself. But by the image of my cause, I see the portraiture of his. I shall court his favors, but sure. The bravery of his grief did put me into a towering passion.
Peace. Who comes here?
Oh,
your lordship is right. Welcome back to Denmark.
I humbly thank you, sir. Dost know this waterfly?
No, my lord.
The state is for more gracious.
Sweet lord! If your lordship were at leisure, I should impart a thing to you from his majesty.
I receive it with all diligence of spirit.
Oh. Sir, here has newly come to court Laertes. Believe me, an absolute gentleman full of most excellent differences. A very soft society and great showing. Indeed, to speak feelingly of him, he is the car or calendar of gentry. For you shall find in him the continent of what part the gentleman would see.
I take him to be a soul of great article.
Your lordship speaks most infallibly of him.
Irrelevant, sir. Why do we wrap the gentleman in our more rawer breath?
Sir? Is it not possible to understand in another tongue? You will do it, really.
What imports the mention of this gentleman?
Of Laertes!
This purse is empty already. All's gone murder's fancy.
Of him, sir!
I know you're not ignorant.
Why would you did, sir? Yet if you did, it would not much approve me. What, sir?
You are not ignorant of what excellence Laertes is.
I dare not confess that, lest I should compare with him in excellence. But to know a man well were to know himself.
I mean, sir, for his weapon.
What's his weapon?
Rapier and dagger.
Well, that's two of his weapons, but well,
the king, sir, has laid... has laid them in a dozen passes between door and him. He shall not exceed 3 hits. He hath already laid on 12 for 9, and it would come to immediate trial if your lordship would vouchsafe the answer.
How if I answer not, my lord?
The opposition of your person in trial.
Let the foils be brought. The gentleman willing and the king hold his purpose. I shall win for him if I can, but if not, I shall gain nothing but my shame and the odd hits.
Oh, shall I re-deliver you, and in so?
To this effect, after what flourish your nature will.
Oh, I commend my duty to your lordship.
Yours, yours! He does well to commend it himself. There are no tongues elsewhere. Oh,
Lapwing runs away with shell on his head.
You will lose this wager, my lord.
I do not think so. Since he has gone into France, I have been in continual practice, but it is no matter.
Nay, good my lord, if your mind dislike anything, obey it. I will forestall their repair hither and say you're not fit.
Not a whit. There is a special providence in the fall of a sparrow. If it be now, 'tis not to come. If it be not to come, it will be now. If it be not now, yet it will come. The readiness is all, since no man has aught of what he leaves. What is to leave betimes? Let be. Not himself does wrong Laertes, then Hamlet does it not. What I have done, then might your honor roughly awake, I here proclaim was madness.
I do receive your offered love like love, and will not wrong it.
I embrace it for you. Give us the foils.
Come, one for me.
I'll be your foil, Laertes. For in mine ignorance, your skill shall, like a star in the darkest night, stick fiery off.
You mock me, sir.
No, by this hand.
Cousin Hamlet, you know the wager.
Very well, my lord. Your grace has placed the odds on the weaker side.
But since he's better, therefore we have odds.
This one is too heavy. Let me see another.
This one likes me well.
If Hamlet give the first or second hit, the king shall drink to his better brother. And in the cup a pearl shall he throw, richer than that of 4 successive kings of Denmark's crown have worn. Come, begin, and Osric, bear you a wary eye.
Come. Thank you, Lord Hamlet!
Hamlet!
late. I dare not drink yet, madam. I am fine.
Come, let me.
My lord, I'll hit him now.
I do not think it. And yet it's almost against my conscience. Come, for the third, Laertes. But dally, I pray you pass with your best violence. I'm afeard you make a wanton of me.
Say you so? Come on.
Free of it. Oh. Wretched queen, and you. Story.
sing thee to thy rest.